Breaking news today. Crime breaking now, cops just took over Obama's DC office, it's about time. For all the frustration that the left likes to voice about President Trump, there was just as much from conservatives about Obama. It just left less of an impression because conservatives weren't willing to riot or break the law. The hardworking middle class sat through 8 years of the Obama administration, biding our time till we would be able to put someone with our interests at heart in the White House. When what is now being called the silent majority spoke up, it surprised many and infuriated the formerly unchallenged squeaky wheels. Now, the left acts like it's somehow being persecuted, because they didn't get their way in 2016. That, of course, leads to a lot of lashing out and even more law-breaking. While it would be ideal if no one ever broke the law, it's sad that it seems to be just the side that didn't encourage division who is receiving the backlash. This, of course, has been the case with our former commander-in-chief, who has been dubbed with sainthood by his fans, despite all he did to encourage division and racism in this country. This week, though, that divisiveness finally caught up to him and he received a taste of what the right has had to deal with ever since his party got the entire nation whipped into a frenzy with their lies about the 2016 election and the scandal that went with it. Fox 5 DC reports that Barack Obama's DC office was closed down as they investigate a white powdery substance that was mailed to that office. DC Fire and EMS Battalion Chief Edward Smith tells Fox 5 a letter was mailed to the West End office from Hong Kong, and reportedly contained baby powder. Authorities say had no return address. D.C. Police and fire crews responded as well as the FBI and Secret Service to 1250 24th Street in Northwest DC. There were no reports of injuries or anyone being evacuated from the building. The Obama family lives in DC's Kalaurama neighborhood, not far from the office building. It is unclear if the former president was in the office when the incident was reported. Fox News reports that London police were investigating a suspicious package Tuesday after a letter containing white powder was sent to an office in the Palace of Westminster, authorities said. Obviously, it's a tragedy anytime someone breaks the law and tries to terrorize someone else. However, it's a crying shame when one side of the political aisle receives abuse, and the other side is completely unsympathetic because they've never had to deal with the same type of issue. In other words, if one side is willing to play dirty and the other isn't, that would make for a very uneven fight. This is the second such problem this week. On Monday, President Trump's daughter-in-law Vanessa Trump, wife of Donald Trump Jr., was taken to the hospital in New York after opening an envelope containing a white powder. Vanessa Trump reportedly opened a letter about 10 a.m. that was addressed to her husband. Police said that she called 911 a short time later and said she was coughing and felt nauseous. Fox News reported that she was taken to the hospital as a precaution and there was no indication anyone suffered injuries. A preliminary test of the powder indicated it wasn't dangerous, a police spokesman said. Sources told Fox 5's Linda Schmidt that the substance was cornstarch and that the envelope had a Boston postmark. Detectives from the NIPT's Intelligence Division and Secret Service agents are investigating. The Secret Service and our law enforcement partners in New York City are investigating a suspicious package addressed to one of our protectees received today in New York, New York, the Secret Service said in a statement to Fox News. This is an active investigation and we cannot comment any further. President Trump spoke to Vanessa Trump, White House spokeswoman Sarah Huckabee Sanders said. Sanders said she could not comment further because of the investigation. Trump Jr. tweeted, "Thankful that Vanessa and my children are safe and unharmed after the incredibly scary situation that occurred this morning. Truly disgusting that certain individuals choose to express their opposing views with such disturbing behavior." Fox News reported that Trump Jr. ditched his Secret Service detail for a period of time in September, reportedly because he wanted more privacy. But his detail was apparently reactivated about a week later. The Trump Organization didn't immediately respond to a request for comment. The Secret Service is still investigating these two events, and the traffic in the area will be shut down until their investigation makes more headway. However, both of these incidents should stand as proof that political tensions are at an all-time high in this country. When you ask yourself what led to this condition, it's painfully apparent that the mistake America made almost 10 years ago in electing Barack Hussein Obama is going to leave a scar for a long time to come. Not because he is black, or because he's a liberal, but because he perpetuated a culture of hatred and division. Thanks for watch. Please subscribe channel for latest news.